just a damn.
Talking about my generation.
Just because we get around.
Talking about my generation.
Things they do look awful.
Talking about my generation.
I hope I die before I get old.
Talking about my generation.
I'd rather leave while I'm in love, while I still believe the meaning of the word. I'll keep my dreams and just pretend that you and I were never meant to end. Too many times I've seen the rose die on the vine. Somebody's heart gets broken, usually it's mine. I don't want to take the chance of being hurt again. And you and I can't say
was a million to one shot, but he's about to show the world he's one in a million.
Why don't you stand up and fight this guy hard like you've done before? That was beautiful.
Rocky II, the story continues.
I was wondering if you wouldn't mind marrying me very much.
I do.
Thanks.
The love continues.
You're the best thing ever come my crazy life.
Faster! Faster!
The courage.
The doctor said you shouldn't fight anymore.
You recommend that I don't fight, and I recommend that I do.
The challenge.
I want all of America, I want the whole world to see me destroy this man after two short rounds.
Right. Rocky, do you think you have a chance this time against Apollo?
I don't know, he looks pretty mad.
The hope.
I never asked you to stop being a woman, you know. Please, don't ask me to stop being a man.
Free!
The tears.
He's going to get hurt because of you.
Well, if he goes blind, you walk away. I can't. I love him. You don't.
The joy.
He's really us. Adri, I can't believe you've done this.
The pain.
Don't worry about nothing. You just sleep as long as you want, okay? And I'm going to be here when you wake up.
The struggles.
You go back to being a two-bit nut.
The dreams.
I think we ought to knock his block off.
Absolutely.
15 rounds for the heavyweight championship of the world.
I think you're going to see a real great battle in every sense of the word.
That's what this fight is going to be. It's going to be a war.
You're going down, man. You're going down.
The most electrifying rematch in motion picture history. Rocky II, starring Sylvester Stallone, Talia Shire, Burt Young, Carl Weathers, and Burgess Meredith. Rocky II, the story continues.
In the not-too-distant future, there will be no civilization. There will be no heroes.
They say people don't believe in heroes anymore. Well, damn them! You and me, Max. We're gonna give them back their heroes!
In the not-too-distant future, there will only be madmen and the main force patrol. Max is a main force officer trying to protect his family and stay alive. His only weapon, 600 horses of fuel-injected vengeance. Mad Max, the maximum force of the future.
Everyone knows the glorious story of the child born in a faraway manger. Well, this isn't that story. This is Monty Python's all-new Life of Brian.
They call Brian.
He was born into the golden age of Roman rule.
Do we have any crucifixions today?
139, sir. Special celebration.
It was a time of miracles.
I was blind and now I can see. Oh!
Friendly persuasion. And gracious invaders. But there was just one thing on everyone's mind.
Sex, 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 that's all they think about her.
Oh dear.
In those days, getting stoned wasn't against the law. It was the law. And things looked bad.
The Romans.
For the people of Jerusalem.
Still a few crosses left.
Until Brian dropped in. He was a born leader.
Brothers, brothers, we should be struggling together.
We are.
A potential martyr.
What would they do to me? Oh, you'll probably get away with crucifixion.
Crucifixion?
Yeah, first offense.
And his mother's joy.
You mean telling them?
They think I'm the Messiah, Mum.
Ah! The Messiah!
There's no Messiah in here. There's a mess, all right, but no Messiah.
And now, it's up to Brian to deliver a despairing nation from the throes of oppression. Tough luck, Jerusalem. This is the life of Brian. Just when you thought you were saved. It's Monty Python's Life of Brian. He wasn't the Messiah. He was a very naughty boy.
Terrific race, the Romans. Terrific.
The end, beautiful friend. hadn't been a soldier since I was 19, and I still haven't learned how to wait for it. I wanted a mission for my sins. They gave me one. Nobody'd ever gone on a mission like it before. And when it was over, I'd never want another one.
Your mission is to proceed up the Nung River in a Navy patrol boat. Pick up Colonel Kurtz's path at New Mung Ba. When you find the colonel, infiltrate his team by whatever means available and terminate the colonel's command.
Terminate?
Terminate with extreme prejudice.
My orders say I'm not supposed to know where I'm taking this boat, so I don't. But one look at you and I know it's gonna be hot.
Pick your boat up and put it down like a baby right where you want it.
This is the first of the night. Air cav, son.
We're coming low out of the rising sun, and about a mile out, we'll put on the music. It scares the hell out of the stokes. My boys love it.
Smell of napalm in the morning. Smells like victory.
Man, this is better than Disneyland.
Short, and we gotta go up there so you can kill one of our own guys.
You're mad, I'm mad. You think you're mad, huh?
They're all dead, stupid.
Who's the commanding officer here?
I hear you.
Ain't you?
He was close. He was real close. I couldn't see him, but I could feel him.
These are all his children, man, as far as you can see.
They think you've come to take him away, and I hope that isn't true.
Could we talk to Colonel Kurtz?
You don't talk to the colonel. Well, you listen to him.
Are you an assassin? I'm a soldier. You're an errand boy sent by grocery clerks to collect the bill.
Land of fascination with a tempting and distinctive cuisine. For authentic Indian dishes, visit this restaurant. The atmosphere of India and Indian courtesy will add to your enjoyment.
Mr. Savalas?
Yes.
Your agent.
Yes?
Howdy, baby. How are you?
Have I got one for you?
You're going to drink Bacardi in a commercial.
But I already drink Bacardi.
No, I know that. You know that, but they don't know that. Listen, they want you to drink it where it comes from, in the Bahamas.
But I am drinking it in the Bahamas.
So I know that, you know that, but they don't know that. All I want you to do is say it tastes good.
I've always said it tastes good.
Sorry. I know that. You know that, but they don't know that.
Bacardi rum. With a character all of its own.
Kelly! I thought you was changing your agent.
I know that. You know that. But he don't know that.
This is the Ford Escort that gave us our eighth consecutive victory in the RAC Rally and clinched the 1979 World Rally Championship. This is the Ford Escort we built to celebrate. A special edition with 1600cc engine, alloy wheels, sport suspension, spoilers, and Recaro seats. We call it the Escort Harrier. Like all Ford Escorts, it's rally bred. Wouldn't you like to take off in a Harrier?
No, Ginger. Leave this one to me.
Herr Commandant, the British colonel insists on seeing you. Can't you see I'm busy? He says it is urgent.
I have every reason to believe the Allies will be here within 2 weeks.
2 weeks, eh? Just enough time to get used to the taste.
Of silk cut king size.
Film girls, I gave Colonel Harris and his boys 2 weeks to get used to the amazingly mild taste of silk cut. Let's see how they're getting on.
Hello, boys. Hope I'm not interrupting anything. Looks like you're really enjoying the amazingly mild flavor of silk cut.
My chaps, let them have it.
It is a gold idea, and there's none better than this one here. Silk cut king size will satisfy you. Just give this mild flavor a wink or two.
Well, folks, there you have it once again. Conclusive proof that it just takes 2 weeks to get used to mild silk cut. By the way, you still having trouble with those stubborn stains?
Today, even bigger than before, fashion for the 80s, Vespa style. The new line range has a model to suit everyone. Vespa mania, you just can't escape it.
We're the Vespa.
You got power to spare.
We're the Vespa.
You can choose what you wear.
We're the Vespa.
You can't go anywhere.
Vespa, today is still the leader in style.
Vespa mania is at your dealer now. Don't miss it.
Sally, Sally, don't ever wander away from the alley and me. Sally, Sally, priority, you're more than the whole world to me.
Worthington E, that's beer. Thank you.
Hey, Eddie.
How come you're such a big hit with the girls?
You can tell from what I'm drinking that I'm really kind of smooth. Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. I'll take a Pepsi from the counter and I stroll up to the booth. Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. And when I get to where they're sitting, that's my chance to treat these kittens to a Pepsi.
Pepsi Cola. Uh-huh.
I take another sip and I kiss them on the lips. Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. They don't put up a battle when I make the ice keeps rattle. My social life is busy since I've been buying lots of Pepsi.
It's like a Pepsi Cola.
Gentlemen, your projectionist tonight is Eric, who has a hot, thirsty job, which he does very well, and unlike you, hasn't time to get himself a refreshing drink of Kia Ora. Thank you.
They don't build anymore. A relic of a time when the world wasn't in such a hurry, when there was still time for a little charm and elegance. It has stood empty for a long while, and at the price, it is a bargain. For a growing young family, it is almost too good to be true.
What do you think?
I love it.
James Brolin, Margot Kidder, Rod Steiger, in the Amityville Horror.
God's peace in this house.
Get out!
Hello?
Hello, Kathy? Father Delaney, there's something very important.
After the Lutz family moved into their dream house, they were running for their lives. What happened to them is an experience in terror you will never forget, and you will believe in the Amityville Horror. From the best-selling book that made millions believe in the unbelievable, the Amityville Horror.